Our expertise comes in the development of drug delivery tools and new methods for analyzing cellular immune responses. One of the approaches that we're excited about is based on enhancing an existing cell therapy for cancer that's in clinical development called adoptive cell therapy. And in this approach, what's done is you collect immune cells from a patient, for example, from a tumor biopsy, expand those cells in cell culture, and essentially use biochemical techniques to identify T cells from those samples that have strong anti-tumor activity, grow those up into large numbers, and reinfuse that sort of tumor-specific army back into the patient. One of the limitations of the current adoptive T cell therapy approaches is that we don't infuse just the T cells back into the patient, but we also will give systemic application of adjuvant drugs that support those T cells. And as with many chemotherapies, we give these adjuvant drugs like interleukin-2 systemically throughout the whole patient via intravenous infusion. And unfortunately, those adjuvant drugs have serious side effects, serious toxicity. So the idea we had is to actually attach a suitcase of drug to each individual cell by encapsulating that adjuvant drug molecule in a nanoparticle carrier that we physically attach to the surface of the T cells. And then each one of these nanoparticles will release that drug over time, a very tiny amount that can stimulate the cell that's decorated with those particles, but not influence the other cells in the tissue. So now we're crossing new hurdles because it's a different thing to treat cancer in the lab versus thinking about starting clinical trials and the issues that come up with moving things into patients. From the perspective of immunotherapy in particular, I think it's an exciting time to bring together biologists and engineers because we're beginning to understand how tumors suppress immune responses and what regulatory checkpoints keep the immune system from attacking cancer. The advantage of being here comes in the opportunities for new collaborations. They come about just by the increased interactions that we have with one another.